So for those of you who are watching this video online, okay, here I go again having to deal with Metro Transit. I get on this bus, my chair has metal hoops, he's got metal hooks, there's cloth straps on here that are only for buses that don't have the proper tie downs, and I rarely ever use it because I have an elevating chair, so when you hook it on wrong, it bends my chair. And this driver won't listen to me, and he thinks he knows it all, and he won't hook up my chair safely. Now he's keeping everybody on this bus waiting, and I'm gonna keep this camera on until this is resolved. So I've called the police, the supervisors are gonna come, and you people watching this video will see what it's like to deal with Metro Transit and being in a wheelchair. So here we go again. You should see all the videos I've already done of this kind of crap. Since my camera is on, I may just explain another thing with Metro Transit. I phoned their number. I asked them, how do I get to this particular location? And they tell me Route 21 and 52. So I go out in the edge of town. That's right, guys, because this guy's going to keep us waiting forever.
I hope not. I want to get home.
He doesn't want to hook up my chair properly.
Why not?
He's got metal hooks. My chair is made from metal hooks on the bottom. There's metal hoops down there. These straps that are here only when the buses really don't have the proper tie downs, because when you hook it on here, it twists my chair. I have an elevating chair, right? All he's gonna do is put the metal hook down there in the metal hoop where it belongs, and he's being an asshole and he's holding it. This is what he's doing to everybody. See, can you believe this? He won't hook up my chair properly. I've got a broken back and I don't wanna have my chair bouncing all over the place. So anyway, I'm just gonna talk to my camera so I don't bore people to death when they watch this on YouTube. So before I left my house, I got instructions on how to get to where I wanted to go, which is on the edge of Halifax, which is called Bears Lake. So I get up to Bears Lake, I want to come back home, and I discover that on the side of the street that I need to catch my bus, there's no accessible bus stops. So I go back on the other side of the street, and the 21 pulls up. And he tells me, well, it's a 45-minute loop all the way around before I come back. I said, well, I guess I don't want to go for that long ride, so I'll wait for the 52, which I was told is accessible for buses, for wheelchairs. The 52 pulls up, which is a Nova articulated bus, and it's completely impossible for me to use it because they want me to back up against a post, and they want to tie my chair down with only one strap, and this chair has a plastic backrest, and these chairs tilt, right, see?
Yeah.
So every time he puts the brakes on, my chair would crush me against the back of the backrest, and this is all plastic. So it's impossible for me to get on that bus. But Metro Transit claims that the Nova buses are safe for wheelchairs, and they argue with you, and I tell them, everybody I know that's got electric wheelchairs can't use that bus. It shouldn't even be allowed to pick up wheelchairs at all. These are made with four tie downs because the chairs weigh 750 pounds, okay? And the idea of putting only one long strap on that hooks on the side on an angle, if he turns around or if the surface is slippery or it's wet, the chair is going to slide over across the floor. Well, these guys think they know everything. Nobody in wheelchairs uses those buses, and they put them on the main routes. So if you go somewhere and you need to get on that bus and an over-articulated bus comes, you're stranded there, which is what happened to me up there. So I should have been back where I wanted to go 2 hours ago. So I get on this bus and this guy's got this attitude telling me how to tie down my own chair. I'm in this chair, not you, and I know how to use my chair. Can you believe this? So this is gonna get a lot of hits on YouTube. I'll have to figure out a good title for it. I put other ones up before and people see these videos and they go, are you serious to treat people like that in Halifax? I said, yeah. That's why I gotta have the camera so I can prove what's happening, because I haven't done anything. All he's got to do is unhook it from there and just put on the metal, and look at him, he's sitting there like an idiot instead of just doing it properly. And he tells me that he knows what he's doing. Look at him.
Hook on the hook right there.
Yeah, that hook was on the metal hoop. See the metal hoop on my frame? There's four of them. And look at him. That's what I got to deal with. Can you imagine how stupid they are? And this is what he's doing to all the passengers.
How long has this been here? How long have you been here?
Not that long. I've been trying to get home. I got stranded up in Bears Lake for 2 hours because the 52 couldn't take me home.
Think about it. If you get that up here, that's going to slide that way.
No, no. If he's got it on the strap, right, that strap is attached to my seat. It's not attached to the chair.
Yeah.
The seat moves.
Yeah.
And when he's going around with my weight and the weight of this chair, what it does, it bends the chair. It's not safe to have it hooked up, and it's not meant to be that way. When they manufactured these and put metal hooks on them, they have to have metal hooks on the buses to hook the chair down properly. He knows how to hook it on properly, he's just being an asshole. There's four hooks.
Right?
No, don't touch it because I'm going to keep my camera going, right?
Okay.
So I can prove what he's doing to me. But he's not just doing it to me, he's doing it to everybody that had to get off this bus. And he wants to make it look like I'm the bad guy. All I'm asking him to do is to tie my chair down properly. Watch this. You'll be the witness to this.
Good day. How are we doing today?
I wish you'd have better drivers that are better educated.
What's the problem?
Okay. I've got four metal hoops on this chair.
Yep.
He's got the metal hooks. I asked him to put the hooks on the metal hoops, and he says, oh, the straps are made for that. I said, I never use the straps because it twists my chair. Okay, I asked him to hook up this chair properly. Now, my camera's on, I'm recording it, so I want to see what your smart answer is going to be. It's going to be like his, doing this to everybody.
So you're taking liability if we damage your chair, right?
What are you talking about?
No, you just finished.
These straps are attached to my seat frame.
Yep.
It's not attached to the frame of the chair. This is an elevating chair, so the seat is not really attached to the bottom, okay? The straps, I don't want straps on this chair at all. The only reason they're on there is because half your buses don't have proper equipment. I have metal hoops, they're made for those hooks. I asked him to put the metal hoop into the frame, and he wouldn't do it. It's such an easy thing to do. I don't know, but why wouldn't he do it?
Well, it's gonna be done anyways.
It's gonna be done.
But it has to be hooked up properly. I don't want my chair moving around.
No problem.
I know it's not.
We don't have to be belligerent about it.
No, he shouldn't have put anybody through this. With a smug look on his face.
These are good loops here.
Yeah, I never even got to look at them because he just started being very belligerent.
Okay. So you're going to be okay if I put them on?
Did you hear him? Yeah. Me being belligerent?
Are we going to be okay if we put them in there? And you
just hook him. That's what I asked him. Just hook on the metal frame.
Hook them in these right now.
Where it belongs.
Yeah.
Thank you.
There you go. That's perfect.
My new chair I'm getting in a couple of months won't even have straps on it at all.
Oh, so are they?
Yeah, the manufacturer doesn't approve it and they won't allow anybody to put them on.
Can you move your bag there?
There you go.
And I think I should probably just take those straps off when I go home. These chairs were never made to have straps on them.
No.
So the manufacturers will tell you that if you get hurt when you've got straps on here, it's Metro Transit responsible because they're demanding people to put them on their chairs when the chairs aren't made for it.
But now you're all
DUP that's demanding that.
Who?
Public Works, not us.
Yeah.
The hooks work though, the hooks you guys.
You mean the guys, usually you got a white shirt on. I was going to say the guys with the white shirts on. That can't see this time.
Yeah, things are working out great.
Okay, so you got all four on?
Go.
I'm going to turn this on and watch. This is why I want them. Watch this, okay? This chair, he's got it tied on, but it moves a lot, right?
Yeah.
And when you do it this way and I move it back and forth, the chair doesn't move. I've got a broken back, a whole bunch of broken ribs. When the chair's moving around, it's really, really painful. I hardly ever get on buses anymore because of these kind of problems. You know what started all this? When I left my house, I asked for instructions on how to get up to Bears Lake and get back home. They told me I can take the 52. Well, the 52's got the Nova articulated bus.
Mm-hmm.
It's impossible for this chair to go on that bus. And all electric wheelchairs cannot go on that bus.
So we shouldn't be carrying really electric wheelchairs?
Not on that bus, not with only one strap. When these chairs are designed for four, and you want me to back up against a steel post with a cushion on it, and I got a plastic backrest.
Yep.
The back wheels on this are made to go up so I can go over curbs. So every time he puts the brakes on, my whole chair tilts. So I've got 750 pounds pushing against my back. And that happens to everybody in wheelchairs. And not only that, we've all got knapsacks in the back. Whoever the idiot was that let those Nova buses go on the streets claiming they're safe for wheelchairs, okay, I wrote a report.
You got to take it up with...
No, I already did all the work. You guys don't care. I wrote the report. Metro Transit doesn't care. Metro Transit.
Yeah, I care. I can't do anything.
I wrote a report for the Disabilities Commission.
Yep.
I used to be a mechanic. I used to own my own shops. I know all the laws about vehicles, okay? I wrote a report that it clearly explains exactly what's wrong with the Nova bus and how dangerous they are and how ridiculous it is to face a wheelchair backwards. Anyway, the report is very well written. The Disabilities Commission has it. Metro Transit got a copy of it. It's published online, and they chose to ignore it.
Maybe they didn't choose to
ignore it. No, they chose to ignore it.
Maybe they forwarded it off and waited for a response.
I've got four tie-down points, right?
Yep.
So you got a long strap that you hook it on, which is about 6 feet long, and it goes on an angle. So there's nothing holding the chair to the floor, and if you make a sharp turn and the floor is wet with snow and ice or whatever, the chair is going to slide across the floor. But why everybody in wheelchairs can't use it? Because they can't back up against that post. And then this guy said that everybody that I know that's got wheelchairs can't use the Nova bus. But Metro Transit doesn't listen to people in wheelchairs. So you got these buses on the main routes and I can't use them.
On this one here, it's got frames built right in, so...
They all do. All wheelchairs have that.
Yeah. Right here, rather than knees. So the frames are there, we can do it.
Yeah, but all electric wheelchairs have the metal hoops on them. All of them do. They're all made for that.
We'll have to visit that on our meeting.
They haven't made a wheelchair without metal hoops in at least 25 years.
Yeah.
These things here are not legal for these chairs. Yeah. The manufacturers don't want these on here because it breaks the chair.
Looped it here.
So I understand what straps do you not want on your chair?
I'm going to be taking these off when I get home. I'm not going through this anymore. Yeah. Those shouldn't be on here.
Blue strap is not doing no good for you.
Well, look where it's attached. It's attached to my arm, right? Of my chair. And this arm goes up and down. It's not even attached.
That's like, chair.
It's so unsafe to have it on there.
So the 4-point tie down we have now is not big?
Not the straps. No, these not
things,
at all.
No, now it is. Now it is. Now it's on the frame.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
But he just had that.
And you just put the other one on and he's off to go. You okay to go?
As long as he doesn't hook it on the straps.
No, okay.
Okay, fine.
All right.
Perfect now.
Done? Can I cancel a police up that pulled up now?
Yeah, you can tell why one of you guys was a good guy. You came to the rescue.
Now we're on.
All right. I'm going to take those straps off. That's what I'm going to do because I don't want to use them at all. They're too dangerous to use.
Not for a bunch.
Well, this is a really heavy chair because it elevates. It's twice the weight of most wheelchairs. And it moves around like crazy. Right now it's strapped down and it's not moving much.
So the issue was that before it was on the loop strap.
Yeah, you can't. When you got hooks, right? Especially with
your water street.
Yeah. Well, the reason why the straps are there because some of the buses don't have hooks, or the really old buses. So if I'm in a spot where I really can't get home, I'm going to use it. I don't like it, but I really, and the guys told me that in Halifax, there's two depots for the buses now. So they told me that all the buses that have the old equipment are being kept at the Dartmouth station. They're not even coming into Halifax is what I was told.
I thought the issue was that you didn't want to be strapped in, period.
No, I don't wear the shoulder one.
You want to be strapped properly.
I have a seatbelt on, right? Oh, I have a broken back, but I have the waiver for that one. So that's probably what you thought. You might have heard somebody tell you.
No, the understanding was that somebody was on board with a wheelchair.
Oh, no. I would never want to move around in this bus without my chair tied down. Thank you. Yeah.